I'm Dr. Zyrowski from newvisionxl.com, and in this video, what I want to do is talk about how to avoid the flu naturally, and there's not a better place to do it than outside in a winter wonderland like it is here in Michigan. We currently have 8 inches of snow. So the flu, also known as the H1N1, has been around for over 50 years. It really hasn't changed much. It's remained the same. It's also not considered to be very serious. You know, though you're going to be uncomfortable, you get some fevers, some chills, a little bit of vomiting involved with that. It's not comfortable by any means, but certainly not considered to be a very serious problem. You know, when we look at the flu right now, you know, they call it a big pandemic. There's, you know, you got to be afraid of it, and all these problems are coming out of it. They're pushing a lot of people to get the flu vaccine. And at first it was, you know, everyone over the age of 65 needs to be vaccinated, but then it turned into everyone over the age of 6 months now. And so the thing is that the flu vaccine has proven to be not very useful. You know, at best, they're finding it to be 30% effective. And then when you look at leading researchers around the world, like Tom Jefferson from the Cochrane database, you know, he basically says, you know, the flu vaccine, the studies done on it are deeply flawed. And then, you know, he also said, though rubbish isn't a scientific term, it is what describes the flu vaccine. So, you know, leading researchers around the world aren't putting their pennies behind it. So, you know, I don't know that you should either. But anyway, if you want more about it, you can go ahead and go in the description below, and I'll put a link to an article I wrote on it. So when it comes to, you know, both scientifically and naturally avoiding the flu, there's a couple things that we can do. You know, first of all, we have to consider the flu. It always comes around the same time of year where there's a lot of holidays, a lot of sleep deprivation, eating too much sugar, you know, all the things that are known to drive your immune system down and open up the gateway for, you know, bacteria and viruses to really come in and beat you up a little bit. And then the other thing interesting about the flu is that it always attacks when people aren't getting enough vitamin D, right? So if you look at the sky above me here, you know, we're not getting too much sunshine here in Michigan. You know, last year in Michigan in January, we only had 1 day of sunshine. So to give you an idea, like, you know, when you're supposed to get 30 minutes of sunshine every day in order to get enough vitamin D, people are very vitamin D deficient. So what I'm going to do is give you a couple tips on how you can boost your immune system naturally. And the first is make sure that you're getting enough sleep. So, you know, the T cells are involved with immune response, and it's scientifically proven, there are studies to show that when you get a lack of sleep, the T cells actually decrease and the inflammatory cytokines increase. So that really just opens up the gateway for you to get some sort of illness, viral infection, bacterial infection. So you really want to make sure that you're getting enough sleep during the holidays. 8 hours of sleep is preferable. The other big thing that you can do is increase your antioxidants, okay? So whether you're taking it in supplement form or making sure you're getting a lot of foods rich in antioxidants, antioxidants are always proven to boost your immune system and give you your body the nutrients needed in order to help you avoid getting sick. So let's circle back to vitamin D. Vitamin D is absolutely necessary and probably one of the most scientifically proven things to really help you avoid the flu. So the reason for this is vitamin D is required by the immune cells in order to produce AMPs, also known as antimicrobial proteins. These antimicrobial proteins kill the flu virus and essentially keep you healthy. Now, the next big thing that you can do is watch your sugar intake, right? You know, the holidays are here, right during this big peaked flu season. Everybody's, you know, you got Thanksgiving, you got Christmas, you have New Year's, and everybody's just having a good time eating a lot of sweets and drinking a lot of sodas and things like that. Really make sure that you're watching your sugar intake, because basically what this is going to do is just drag your immune system down and open up the gateways for you to get sick again. So watch your sugar intake, and, you know, use other forms of sweeteners such as xylitol, stevia, erythritol, and from there you'll decrease your sugar intake and it's not going to hurt your immune system. And last if not least, make sure you're getting that exercise in, because exercise is always scientifically proven to boost your immune system and increase T cell activity, which is going to help kill the viruses as well. So exercise is an excellent way to boost your immune system. So once again, I'm gonna post the article in the description below about really this topic of how to avoid the flu. But besides that, I hope that you are making better choices so that you can avoid the flu, stay healthy, and be informed when it comes to natural health. So I hope you make it a great day. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. If you have any further questions, post them in the comments section below.